today's class, I do want you to have a roller. We're just going to use the roller for our feet. So if you don't have a long one, it's fine. We're just using it with our pelvic curl. And let's start with rolling the shoulders. We're doing a pure Pilates class today with the roller. That's it. Good. Rolling those shoulders. And taking the arms out to the side. Rotating, twisting those arms. Warming up your rotator cuff muscles, start your watch if you need. Good, and now nice big circles. Breathing out as you take those arms round. So with any of the exercises today, if you find them a little bit tricky, you can always find, I'll give you an alternative. Nice, all right, let's take a nice breath in. Breathing in, arms up. And breathing out. Squeezing those elbows into your waist, lifting up your chest. Breathing in, arms up, and breathing out as you stretch forward, reaching, nice flat back, pulling your belly button in. If you want to lean on a chair, you can, and then folding down to the ground. And breathing out as you curl up, one vertebra at a time. Think of stacking the vertebra on top of one another, shoulder blades down, head comes up last. And breathing in, and out. Squeezing those elbows into your waist. Breathing in, arms up. And breathing out as you stretch, tummy pull in, reaching away from you, and folding down. And breathing out to curl up, one vertebra at a time, tucking under. One more, breathing in. And out. Tummy pulled in. Breathing in, arms up. And breathing out as you stretch. Reaching those arms away from you. Nice flat back. And folding down to the floor. Good. Coming down onto your knee. Let's put your right leg in front, knee over ankle. Hands on the floor. Slide that back leg back. And we're going to roll those hips side to side. That's it. Rolling the hips, loosening off the hip capsule. And now reaching back, dig that heel in, straightening that front knee. Remember, you can move your hands to wherever you need. And coming forward, lift your chest. We're going for five, going forward and back, sliding and gliding those tissues. Nice, let's go for three more. Dig that heel in, make sure you straighten that knee. Two, digging it in, and coming forward. And last one, reaching back, and coming forward. Lift that chest. Nice, let's change sides. Left leg in front, knee over ankle, hands on the floor, sliding that back leg back. And we're gonna roll those hips side to side. It's a small movement this, don't worry if it doesn't feel like you're doing much. Now stretching back, dig the heel in, straightening that front knee. And coming forward, lift your chest. For four more. We really want to get those tissues sliding and gliding, moving freely against each other. Stretch. Nice. Two more, reaching back. And last one. And forward. Nice. Now we're going to stay down here. We're going to go into our plank and reach and downward dog. So the exercise is in a nice high plank. You're going to reach one arm forward and then touch your toe and come back. If it's too difficult to reach with your one arm, then you can literally go from a plank to a downward dog and back. Okay, let's go. We're going for 10. We've done two. Reach. Touch. When you come back to that plank, slide those shoulder blades down and back. Squeeze your tummy. When you lift your hand, you want to make sure that you're not shifting your shoulders and your hips too much. Remember, stay facing the ground. Let's go for two on each side. Reach. Touch. Reach. Touch. And plank. One more each side. Reach. Touch and plank. So coming back into that high plank, take your right knee in. Then you're gonna reach it up and open up those hips, twisting. Five each side. Again, if you wanna do just a plank to downward dog, you can. So let's go with your right knee, pulling it in and stretch. Try and open up those hips. Tummy pulled in. Five each side. Make this exercise your own. It doesn't matter what it looks like. Just try and stretch. Two more. And last one. Very nice. Hold it here in the downward dog. Place both feet on the ground. Hold the stretch. This is sort of like a little active recovery. And now let's go with your left leg, pulling it in. And reach and open up those hips. Two. Breathe out, stretch. Three. Four. Nearly there. Last one. And coming down into a child's pose, just stretching it out. Taking the weight off your hands for a bit. Nice. Okay, last one in this sort of series. We're going to go into that plank again. You're going to bring your right knee in. And from here, we're going to breathe out and lift the hips. When you lift, you want to imagine lifting from here. So you're in this position, and you're just lifting. It's a small action, and it really is working these muscles. Okay, so let's go. We're doing 10 with the right knee in. Shoulders down and back. Right knee in. Let's go. Two, tummy pulled in. Let's breathe out as you lift. Seven, nine, 10, changing sides. Left leg. Two, three, four, breathing out. Six, seven, eight, nine, 10, and coming down onto your back. Well done. We're going to lie on your back. We're going to do bicycles for a minute. We haven't done bicycles for a while, actually. So lying on your back, legs up to the ceiling, arms by your side, next to your out to the side. And we're going to do nice long pedal strokes for a minute. Let's go. So with this, you really want to think of tilting that pelvis. Nice long legs. Imagine cycling on a penny farthing. Big pedal strokes. Still focus on those abs, pulling in your pelvis. That's it. 20 seconds gone, let's go, 40 to go. Stretch those legs up, lower them as much as you can, keeping your low back on the floor. Long legs. Tummy pulled in. Breathing out as you go. Nice, we've got 20 seconds. Tummy pulled in, tilting that pelvis. Stretch out those legs for 10. Five, three, two, one. Very nice. Stay lying on your mat, you're gonna grab your roller. We're gonna do a little bit of glute work with the roller. So it can be a short one if you've got, or a long one, but don't worry if your only one is a short one. Have your roller quite close to your bottom. So move yourself down the mat as much as you need to be, so that your bottom is close to your heels. Hands by your side, and we're gonna curl up through the pelvis, through the spine, lifting all the way up. That's it, and then breathing out to curl down. Tummy pulled in. Breathing out as you lift. Now push down through the roller. Make sure you're not pushing out. Squeeze that bum. And curling down. We're going for 10. Breathing out. Squeeze. Tummy pulled in. And rolling down through that spine. One vertebra at a time. Four. Nice. Keep lifting. Squeeze. And down. Breathing out to lift. and curling down through that spine. All the way, we've got five more. Push through those heels. Squeeze, clench at the top. When we've got to 10, we're gonna hold it up there. We've got four more. Connect, ready, pull, suck everything in. Beautiful, pushing through those heels, nice work. Two. Squeeze, tilting that pelvis, rolling through the spine. Last one, holding it up there. Reconnect that tilt. You're gonna open and close the knees for 10. Nine, breathe out as you close. Seven, scoop in those abs. Six, five, four, three, two, one. Now hold it there. You're gonna roll the heels out and in. Breathe out as you pull it back in. Eight, seven, tummy pulled in. Six, this is breaking the hammies. Five, four, three, two, one, and curling it all the way down. Well done. Keep the roller under your ankles or your calves, wherever they've rolled out to. My sort of just above my ankles is on the roller. We're gonna do a couple of roll-ups with your feet on the roller. Arms above your head. You're gonna take a nice breath in, arms and head up. Breathing out as you're curling up through that spine. Reaching forward, if you need to bend your knees, you can. Sitting up nice and tall, shoulders slide down and back, and then curling down through that pelvis, and all the way. Nice work, let's go again, breathing in. And breathing out. Coming up through that spine, reaching forward, stretch. Sitting up nice and tall, shoulders down, and curling down. Start at the pelvis. Now you're going to get rid of that roller, so kick your roller out the way, you don't need it anymore. You're going to lift your right leg off the floor. Pull that kneecap up so your leg is nice and strong. And we're going to roll up, breathing in. And breathing out. Now obviously we can't go as far forward. And curl down all the way, tummy pulled in. Leg down, change sides, left leg up. Breathing in. And out. Nice, and curling down. We've got one more each side. Right leg up, breathing in. And breathing out. All the way, curling down. Nice, last time, drop your right leg, left leg up, pull up that quad. And breathing out, and then curling all the way down. Very nice. Coming onto your mat on your stomach, we're gonna do push-ups with a twist. So we're gonna do a push-up, then come up into a rotation. So if you can, I'd like you to do the push-up going down in a full push-up. So if we can, we're gonna be here, go all the way down, drop your knees. Push up if you need, or come up in a full push-up. Then we're gonna twist and rotate. You roll your feet onto their side, then coming back, going down, drop the knees. If you can manage to do a full push-up up and down, that's perfect, you're welcome to. I'm just thinking for those who are trying to get stronger with their push-ups, do the negative going down in a full push-up, and then come up on your knees. Okay, we're going for 10. So if you need to do the push-up on your knees the whole way, that's perfect. Tummy pulled in, shoulders down and back. Let's go. All the way down. Knees. Lift the knees to rotate. Roll your feet onto the side. That's it. Down. Tummy pulled in. Nice and slow. There's no rush for this. Do this in your own time. I'm on number three. If the push-up is too tough, just do the rotation. You can just stay in a plank. Stay up here and just twist. We've got three more each side. very slow and controlled. We're gaining strength with this, guys. Two more each side. Very nice. We are getting there. Whew. This is hard. Nice. We've got one more each side. Pushing up. Whatever you do, don't arch your back. If you need to do the whole thing on your knees, that's absolutely fine. Last rotation. And coming down. Well done. Roll out those wrists if you need. Great job. Grab a sip of water. We're going to go into butt camp. So we're doing one leg, four different exercises, 40 reps, 30 reps, 20 reps, 10 reps. Now you know I battled to count to 10. So 40 is all on you, okay? There's no way I'm counting 40 and getting it right. I'll do my best. Unlikely, but let's see how we go. Coming onto your elbows to start with, you're on your knees and your elbows. Nose over your hands. So that's why you're trying not to get your upper traps working, trying to encourage your lats to work. Let's go with our right leg. Stretch that right leg out. We're going to go for 40, lifting that leg up and down. Let's go. Tummy pulled in. Make sure you're not arching the back. And you're just isolating from that hip. Squeeze. That's 10. Tummy pulled in all the way. Very good. Squeeze. 20. I'm going to have to count my fingers. Very good. Shoulders down and back. That's 30. 10 more. If you're not quite with me, don't worry. Very good. Squeeze that leg nice and strong away from you. 3, 2, 1. Very nice. Coming up onto your hands. Same leg. You're going to tuck the knee to your nose. And then you're going to take your leg and open the hips. So from this position, I'll show you in standing. I'm taking my leg behind me like that. So I'm from here, tuck, and then you want to open, opening up those hips, okay? We're going to go for 30. Let's go. Shoulders down and back. And open. Pull that belly button in. I want you to breathe out as you bring that knee to your nose. We're doing this for the long haul, guys. Keep your form, shoulders away from your ears. Nice. 7, 6. Remember to open up those hips. That's 10. When my leg is behind me, it's parallel to the floor. Nice. Shoulders away from your ears. Good. 15. We're halfway. Keep that leg moving. Shoulders pulled away from your ears. Curl. Tummy pulled in. Nice. That's 20. 10 more. Breathing out as you open. Nice. So this position, you're having to stabilize with your shoulders and that leg on the ground for 3, 2, 1. Now take the same leg. You're going to take it behind your other knee, kick it out to the side. So if I show you from this angle, knee crosses behind, kicks out. You want to try and have this leg in line with your body. Try not to let it go down too low. You're taking knee behind knee and then kicking out for 20. Shoulders down and back, tummy pulled in. Let's go. Knee. Breathing out as you kick. Try and keep that leg in that same line. Nice. Weight evenly on both hands. 7.
have you pulled in?
9.
10 halfway there. 2, shoulders away from your ears.
Nice.
5. 4 more. 3, we are burning. 2. 1. Now last 10, you're gonna take that leg behind you, then kicking out to the side for 10. Behind. Let's go. Take an open behind. So from this way, I'm going there and kick. 4. 3. That's the wrong way. Now we got 4 more. 3 more, tummy in. 2. 1. Well done. Coming back into a child's pose, stretching out those glutes, dropping your head down. Good. Before we do the other side, we're going to do some abs, because that would just be cruel to go straight into your other side. Come and lie on your back. Arms up to the ceiling, palms facing each other. Legs up in tabletop. We're going to go into our dead bug. Tummy pulled in, low back glued to the floor. Tilt that pelvis towards you. Let's go. Breathing in and out. All the way. Focus on those abs. Pulling up that tailbone. 5. Your low back is glued to the floor. 2 more each side. Tummy pulled in. Then we're going to go into our double dead bug. 1 more each side. Now from here, both arms, both legs, stretch away and back. Only lengthen those legs away as much as you can without arching. So if your leg needs to come higher, that's perfect. 4. Tummy stays connected. Low back is glued to the floor. Breathing out. 3 more. 2. 1. Well done. Hug those knees into your chest. Very nice. We're going to go into our single leg swap from here for 10 into double leg swap. Legs up, hands by your side or behind your head. Knees in tabletop, tilt that pelvis. Let's go. Single leg swap. So with this, you want to hinge just from the hip. Your knee angle stays the same, and we just hinge it. Focus on pulling up that tailbone towards your nose. Tummy pulled in. For 3 more. Last 1. Very nice. Now double leg swap. So with this, only lower it down as much as you can without arching. If you find your back arches, stick with the single leg swap. Breathing in and out. Really focus on pulling in those abs. Don't let your back arch. Tummy pulled in. We've got 4 more. 3. 2. Tailbone lifted. 1. Beautiful, well done. Right, we're going to do our other side. Remember which leg we just used? It was the right leg. We're now going to use the left leg. So, coming onto your hands and your elbows. Nice. You're going to stretch out your left leg. Tummy pulled in. Get your nose over your hands. 40, let's go. Tilt your pelvis. With this, making sure you're not arching your back, it's just the leg that's moving. Slide those shoulders away from your ears. That's 10. Get your nose over your hands, tummy in. Nice, extend that leg. Beautiful job. 20, halfway. Breathe out, tummy in. I'm counting on my fingers, I think I've got this. Nice. three, two, one. Very nice. Coming up onto your hands. Resetting your shoulder blades, tummy pulled in. Left leg, you're going to bring knee to nose and open. We're going for 30. Let's go. Nice. Tummy pulled in, but you do open up those hips. So you want to keep that control. I don't want you swinging your legs wildly away. It's all controlled. Eight. Tummy pulled in. Breathe out as you bring that knee to nose. That's 10, got 20 more. Nice. Control it. Abs in. Shoulders away from your ears. Five. Knee to nose. Good. We're coming up to 20, 18, 19, 20, last 10. Breathing out, use that control, and it's also nice to open up those hips. Good, nice and strong. Five more, five, four, three, two, one. Fantastic. Now from here, 20. Knee behind the knee, knee. Kicking out. Let's go. One. Two. Try and keep your hands evenly. Three. If you need to take a little break, join back in. Shoulder blades slide down and back. Tummy away from the floor. Whew. Two more. Then we go to 10. Nine. We've got last 10. Let's go. One. Two, control that leg. Three, keep it high. Four. Five. Whew, this is burning. Seven. Eight. Nine. 10. Very nice, we've got 10 more. Same leg. We're gonna take the leg. Open behind. Kick out to the side for 10. Let's go. One. Two. Going for 10. If your wrists are getting sore, come onto your fists. Keep that leg high. You want to try. Keep the leg parallel to the floor the whole way. Five. Six. Seven. Tummy in. Eight. Nine. 10. Well done. Awesome job. Have a little stretch. Very nice. All right, coming lying on your back. We're going to roll like a ball, then go into the rocker. Now we're going to add a new exercise on. I don't expect everyone to be able to do this. Okay, it's quite a lot of mobility. So I'm going to show you. We're going to roll like a ball first for five. Then go into the rocker. If the exercise I'm about to do after that is too much, you're just going to come up and you're going to do some squats. Okay, so we'll get there. Right, let's roll like a ball. Hold onto your shins, tuck your head in. Breathing in, keep that ball position. Breathing out as you roll up. Tummy pulled in, you can hold behind your knees, that's perfect. Try not to pull on your knees. Use your abs. Now we're going to go into the rocker. You hold behind your calves or your knees. Out of balance. We're going for four. Nice. Keep that balance. Two more. Last one. All right. Now I'm going to show you the next variation on this. I don't expect you all to do this, but if you can just try. Maybe, okay, let's go. So we're going to start with the rocker, rolling like a ball. Feet up and you're going to stand up. It sounds harder than it is. If you struggle with that, I want you just to stand up and give me some squats. Okay, because we're going to stand and do squats now. So, roll back. Have your arms in front, come and stand up. it. Try and keep your feet together. You want to keep your feet together. So from the front, that's it. We're going. Nice. Feet and knees together. Give me two more. Perfect. One. Very nice. Right. Staying up and standing. We're going to go into our squats all together. Up nice and tall. You're going to take your arms up and down. We're going for 10. Let's go. Shoulder blades slide down and back. Breathing out as you're coming up. Tummy pulled in. At the top, really squeeze everything. Use those arms. Nice. We've got 5, 4. Breathing out. Tummy pulled in. 3, 2. You can use your cat as a weight. 1. Now hold it down there. We're going to pulse for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. Lift your chest. 2, 1. Now stay down there. Lift up one heel and down. Alternate heels. Drop your bottom. Keep your tummy pulled in. Nice. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And come and stand up. Well done. Staying and standing, you're going to stand on your left leg. Reaching up with your right arm. We're going to bend forward, touch your foot with your opposite hand. So we're going to reach down towards your toe and come and stand up. That's it, opposite hand. If you want, you can just reach for your knee. What I do want is that you actually stick your bottom out so your back is nice and flat. If it hurts your back, keep it nice and contained. We're going for 10, we've got 5 more. Good. 4, this is all about your balance and working that glute. 3, 2, and last 1. Let's change legs. Standing on your right leg, left hand up in the air. Let's go. If you want to stop at your knee, that's perfect. As long as you're working your balance, you can stop here. Tummy pulled in all the time. We're really trying to work those balance, those all the muscles in the ankle, the knee, the hip, to hold you there. We've got 5. Tummy pulled in. 4. Shoulders away from your ears. 3. Oopsie, find a spot to balance. 2. Tummy in. And last 1. Very nice. Let's stand up nice and tall. We're going to go back down to the mat. We'll take a deep breath in. And let's curl down. 1 vertebra at a time. All the way. Holding it down here. Grab your elbows. And just hang. Let it stretch. Rock side to side. Nice. Right. Coming down onto your mat. Last exercise before we go into stretching. You're going to lie flat on the mat with your legs straight. Left leg straight. Right leg up to the ceiling. If you can't keep that right leg straight, then I want you to bend it. This leg on the floor must be straight. We're going to do little circles on the ceiling, either with your knee or with your toe. Hands by your side, tummy pulled in. You're really squeezing this left core muscle, this left TA. Keep that hip nice and flat. 8 circles one way. 2 more. 1, and now 8 the other way. Both hip bones must stay dead still. Don't let them move. Use that core. You can use, make some circles with your knee. 2, 1, very nice. Now we're going to go to big hip circles. Take it out to the side. Make sure this left hip stays down. And across. We're going for 5 this way. Tummy pulled in. You keep this hip down as the leg goes out. One more. Now reverse it. So now we go across. All the way around. Hip stays down. Tummy's connected. Five this way. You've really got to work those abs to keep your back and your hip bones down. One more. And hold, hug that knee into your chest. Very nice. Hold that stretch. Taking the right knee, take it out to the side. So you've still got the knee bent, and just take that knee out to the side. You're stretching that hip capsule. If it hurts your knee at all, rest that hand on your, that knee on your elbow. Very nice. While we're here, let's just take this right knee across to the left side, rotating, having a lovely stretch before we do the other side. Breathe out. Use that breath out to get a little bit more range. Good. Coming back to the middle. Let's straighten out your right leg. Left foot or knee to the ceiling. Eight circles one way, little circles on the ceiling. Draw it with your toe, your knee. Keep that right hip flat on the floor. Breathing in and out, tummy in. Reverse direction, other way. So when you take the foot out, away from that right hip, it wants to lift. You want to use your core to keep it flat. Nice, now big circles, five. Keep using those core muscles to keep that right hip down. One more. And let's reverse it. Big circles the other way. When your leg is out to the side, keep that opposite hip on the floor. One more. And bending that knee in towards your chest. Lovely stretch. Good, so I've got my left knee and my chest. I'm going to use my left hand to take that hip out to the side. I feel it click. That's just me with my hips, but it's not sore. If it is sore, give it some support. Nice. Now pull that knee across you to the right-hand side. Stretching that back. Look at your left hand. Very nice. Pulling those knees into your chest. And let's go into our happy baby from here. If you can manage, opening up the knees, grabbing the inside of your feet, and make sure that your knees are wider than your shoulders if you can. And gently, very gently, put pressure down towards the floor. Rock side to side. Very nice. And coming up into sitting. Let's just stretch out those neck muscles up in sitting. Nice. We're going to look over your right shoulder. Roll your chin down onto your chest. All the way to the left. Make sure you're not slumping. Sit up nice and tall. Let's go for two more. And last one. Good. Now let's sit on your right hand, put your right hand under your bum. We're going to stretch out this right traps muscle. So, hand under your right bum, look at your left knee. You can do this sitting in a chair as well if you want. You can sit on a chair, it's easier. You're going to look at your left knee, hand on your head, and gently apply pressure. If you find this uncomfortable sitting cross-legged, rather sit on a chair, same action. Nice, and let's change sides. So hand under your bottom, you want to look at that opposite knee. Now with your hand, try and have your elbow in front of your nose. So you're pulling in that same direction. Very gently. Nice. Awesome job, guys. Thank you so much. That was amazing. I